Today I'm going to be sharing with you how I save 70% on all of the lumber that we use for our garden. Hey y'all, it's Bo Brotherton with Better Together Life and the Shed to House Facebook group. All right, we're here sitting at the garden and it is a big fat mess all over the place in the background because we are redoing all of the garden beds. And we're gonna be building some new ones for this next spring. My wife Kelly is making a big, big push to be able to get as much food growing this spring as possible. All right, so it's kind of a mess back here and Finley's hanging out with me. This lumber is from Home Depot. And if you've ever seen it, it's the lumber that's sprayed purple in these spots. And anything that is sprayed purple is marked off the 70%. Usually you'll see it in the back part of the lumber yard and it'll be like on a cart. Most of the time the lumber there is not going to be useful, but you can do some things, do a little bit of work searching around in the lumber to be able to find these deals for yourself to where you don't have to only do it in the cart. You can find lumber that is going to eventually be cold, lumber that is split, lumber that is bowed, that is perfect for little projects around the homestead, and it really, really good for the garden.
And don't forget shows.
Shows?
Yes, shows.
Lumber has nothing to do with shows.
No.
There's no shows today. No. So whenever I went yesterday to Home Depot, I went to the normal spot for the lumber, and there wasn't any cold items really that I could use. We were looking for cedar because this is going to be used for our garden beds. Now the good thing about cedar is it's a very soft wood. So there is a high probability that it's going to split no matter what. I can show you how the ends of this wood is split. And what I did was I went through and I looked on the sides of all of the edges of the lumber of all the boards, and I just searched for the splits and I searched for any kind of like imperfections of the wood so that I could go and ask someone to say, hey, this looks like it's split, it looks like it's going to be on sale at some point, I'm just using it for a garden bed and this is perfect for me to be able to save some money. What I would suggest is if this is something that you're gonna do, I have a couple of tips to be able to make sure that not only you are successful, but also that you kind of don't ruin it for the rest of us. You don't wanna be that guy to where this, you know, it gets reported to a manager that people are trying to take advantage of the store and rip them off, because that's not good for anybody. The first one that I would say is don't be greedy. Don't try to get, you know, $1,000 worth of cold lumber. Try to go with a small project in mind to be able to get, you know, a good handful of boards. Maybe it retails for anywhere between $200 and $300. That's probably a really good thing to where it's not too big of an item. This was actually over the item, so where it was all 70%, to where they did have to get a manager approval, but there was no problem with that manager approval. So that's the top tip, don't be greedy. The second tip is find someone that is gonna be helpful. Maybe a young person that work in there, or maybe an older person that's working there that is cheerful and happy. You don't wanna have someone that's gonna have to ask the manager.
Quite frankly, sir, I really don't care.
What?
I really don't care.
Okay.
In today's climate right now in 2021, definitely wear a mask. We're in Texas, we don't have to wear masks, but still, it's something that you just want to be respectful. Put on a mask because you want to be able to save the money. You don't want to be controversial. You don't want to stick out like a sore thumb. If the person that is working at Home Depot is wearing a mask, make sure you have one on also. Find someone polite and be polite yourself. All right, the last tip, number three, is going to be do not make a mess. Don't go through and start pulling all of the lumber out and trying to make a big mess, because usually in these spots, then the lumber is already organized. And a lot of the boards that you might want are gonna be down at the bottom. Don't worry about that. You're not gonna get those on that day. So you might have to come back a couple of trips to be able to get some of those lower boards. So focus on the ones that you can have access to where you can move a couple of boards around, you can shift it around, but don't go pulling all the stuff out just so you can find one split board down at the bottom. That's just gonna make things annoying. They're not gonna wanna help you. On this, there was a lot of boards that I left down at the bottom that I wanted because I could see that they were split, but it wasn't something that was worth it to me because I did not want to aggravate the employees there. I didn't want to be that guy. But on this single trip, I was able to get 5 2x6s. I think it was, I got 2 12-footers, 1 10-footer, and then 2 8-footers. And then I was able to get 3 4x4. They're all cedar. They are all in great quality for what I'm wanting to do. Am I going to build a barn with this? No. But is it good enough for a garden bed? Absolutely. If you are paying full price for cedar garden beds, you are just blowing money. You're wasting money. There is good quality cedar lumber that you can get 70% off out there. Let me know down in the comments, how do you find good deals on your lumber? I'd love to learn from you. Put it down in the comments below. What kind of wood are you using for your garden beds this spring? So let me know down below. And we'll see you on the next one. Bye.